I think we're going about everything wrong, particularly the confinement problem, that is vastly underrated. And if anything like the resources currently being spent on interactive security, virus screening, fighting back, all the rest of those things, were spent on the improvement of the logical functioning of devices, which is largely a matter of improving, you know, making another very, very big improvement in the quality of programming, that we would get much, much better results.
We rarely, if ever, have conversations about our technological future and what we'd like to have.
I'll give you my favorite scenario of the future. What happens is, over time, general intelligence gets developed, the singularity occurs, the intelligence gets smarter than humans, the humans have a battle with the general intelligence, and the humans decide to turn off the computers. The intelligence is so smart, it hops from computer to computer, preventing the humans from turning off the computers, and eventually the intelligence wins and humanity is destroyed. That, by the way, is a movie, okay?
Instead of designing our future, we let it come as it comes without forethought or architecting or planning.
We've significantly, in many of these safety critical industries, we've underinvested, and there has to be a catch-up period.
In the clinical environment, the average operating system is Windows XP, and it goes downhill from there.
Trust and safety might be our new goal as an industry, not just our secrets. It's not credit card numbers or the people we meet on Facebook or our private, most intimate wishes. Yes, those are important too, but perhaps life-threatening things, safety things, and trustworthy devices that will power our modern way of life should come first.
Because technology and business practice and our digital revolution are so far out ahead of our understanding that our laws are an insufficient tool to respond to all of the risks.
But to that extent, I have seen a significant shift, right? There is a lot of positive momentum over the last few years to, even from the researcher aspect of, you know, how those relationships were to where they are now.